Hello, today I would like to make a presentation about poison ivy and ties. So here is my screen and I will launch the presentation. So first, of all, poison ivy, Toxicodendron radians, is a plant which produces a toxic oil for us humans on all on its parts, so leaves and stem. If we get in contact with it through our skin, we can get a very bad rash. So it's better not to try it. It's okay for cats and dogs. Nothing will happen unless we pet them and then we can get the bad reaction. So the best thing to do is to be able to identify it. So here people say three leaves, let it be. And in fact, a complete leaf of poison ivy is composed of three foliates, as shown on this drawing. So it's a vine and the plant, so the leaves are along these vines, three foliates, and sometimes we have some edge in the leaves, as we will see next. So now some picture. And it's your job to try to identify poison ivy. So first, on this wall, are you able to see some leaves of poison ivy? So bottom right, it's not a leaf of poison ivy. Because of the picture, we see only three foliates, but actually there is five. So this climbing plant on the right is not poison ivy. But on the left, if you have spotted these leaves, this one, and this one, all these are leaves of poison ivy. You see they are connected to the vine that is on the left. And this vine is a vine of poison ivy. Now, this is a picture of the ground. So it can also just develop on the ground directly, and there is a lot of poison ivy here. Are you able to see it? Did you see those leaves? Those are poison ivy. Those leaves here also are poison ivy, and here there is another one. Now a third example. Again, it's directly on the ground. So what I want to say with this is like along the trails, right on the edges of the trail, poison ivy can be found. And it's better to wear long sleeve pants to be sure to not get in contact with it. So on this picture, here we see poison ivy. We see it also here. We can see it here and we can see it also very clearly in this picture. Is this poison ivy? You may say yes, three leaves, but in fact, no. There is foliates on one leaf. So this plant is not poison ivy. Plus, it's not a vine. So now my second thing, it's ticks. So you know that they may transmit Lyme disease, I want to teach you a little bit about their life cycle and also about the different diseases, because there is not only Lyme that they can that they may carry, and how to prevent and get rid of them. So first, their life cycle. So everything starts in the spring. Ticks eggs hatches and they will become larvae, and once they are larvae, they need to feed those little larvae on a small animal, and it's during this feeding, which can last for several days, that if the host is infected by one of the diseases that the tick can transmit, then the tick will get it from this host. So once the tick is done with the first feeding, fall comes, winter comes, and the next spring, it becomes enough. Once it is enough, it needs to make a second feeding on a big mammal. It can be a human, it can be a deer, a fox, or a small mammal if it doesn't find a big mammal. So that's when we can get infected if the dike was infected by a disease with its first meal. And again, the dike can get infected through the second meal as well. If the nymph is able to complete the second meal entirely, there is a second summer, and in the next fall, it will become an adult. Once the dike is an adult, it needs a third feeding on a big mammal. And then it goes through winter, and in the next spring, it will produce eggs, and the life cycle will start again. So beware, dikes live for 2 to 3 years, and they can be active at any season, even if it's during spring and summer that we have the most risks to get bitten. We could also get bitten in winter, during the winter and during the fall. Yes. So this is to show you how the size of the dike evolve at its different life stages. So from larva is very small, and then nymph is a little bit bigger, and it's the biggest once it's an adult. But compared to a coin, it's the nymph and the larva can still be very small. So we should really pay attention carefully to us after hiking. Have you ever seen a dike that has completed its lunch? It looks like this. Yeah. So now some focus about NGE dikes. They have 8 legs, so they belong to the spider family and not to the insects family. The insects have 6 legs. So dikes are spiders. The first that we can be found here is the American dog dike. Even if a dog is its preferred host, it may bite humans, and it may transmit the Rocky Mountain spotted fever. The second dike is the Lone Star dike, and this one may transmit the Ehrlichiosis disease. And the third one, I would say the most dangerous one because it can transmit the Lyme disease, is the deer tick, also called the black-legged tick. So it may transmit Lyme, but not only. You find also anaplasmosis, babesiosis, and Powassan virus. The symptoms can appear in the first 30 days after having been bitten. Small focus about Lyme disease. So this is what will happen if you get infected by the Lyme disease. So you see the red circle developing around the biting site. These are actually the bacteria evolving in the host. If this kind of thing appear on your skin, go to the doctor and he will prescribe you antibiotics to fight the disease. So how to prevent dikes? First of all, wear long sleeves clothes, pant and t-shirt, long sleeves. That's one barrier between your skin and the dikes. And then apply repellent to any skin parts that are not that are exposed. It's better to use one sunscreen that is only sunscreen and one repellent that is only repellent. It's more efficient than the combo lotions that are sunscreen and repellent at the same time. And then once you are done with being outside, check daily for dikes. They love to be behind the ears, in the neck, but they can be found really anywhere. So be very careful with that. And don't forget that where deer are, dikes are. or tykes maybe. So if deer can come in your backyard, then you might have tykes in your backyard unless you are treating the lawn. Then if you are bitten, what should you do? Remove the tick ASAP, as shown on the picture, and then disinfect and apply bacterial soap. The sooner you remove the tick, the better it is, because until the tick is ready for lunch, it takes a while. So the bacteria takes also a while to infect the host. So you may not get the disease if you remove it quick after it has started to bite. This is all what I wanted to say about ticks. I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and you can contact me if you have any questions through my website. Thank you very much.